Now, there's two major areas where you're going to see fragmentation. One is when we have low MTU sizes on the network, something less than 1500. That's where we'll see fragmentation happen. But another area to look for is when we're looking for malicious scan activity. Now, if you've been studying NMAP or any type of pen testing, you know that one way that we can enumerate a network is by fragmenting our data. Sometimes that's a way that we can get by a firewall or across an IDS. And basically what it comes down to is, you've seen it, you've been driving down the road on the freeway and you see a truck that's really high and you can see an overpass that's really low and you wonder how that truck is gonna get under that bridge. Well, the same idea applies with IP fragmentation. Basically the idea is that the packet that we're trying to send is too big for the maximum transmission unit of a network interface that we're trying to send it through. That's the fundamental idea. So if the MTU is low, we need a mechanism to be able to break up that packet, that IP packet, into smaller chunks to be able to continue to send that data along to its destination. Now, I went ahead and included the trace files that I'm going to be demonstrating in this video, and you can get those in the link down below. So let's actually draw this out to see how it works. All right, so let's try to keep this super simple. Let's just say that there's a station here and he wants to send a packet through a network. Now let's just say that there's a couple of routers here and on the way to our server. And let's just make this very simple. So this machine here, this PC, it's gonna send a message over to our server. Now let's just say that that packet is 1500 bytes. That's at the IP header level, all right? Before we put the Ethernet frame information on there, that would make it a little bit bigger. All right, so here's our packet. Now that goes along its way to the first router. Now let's just say that the next hop has a low MTU, maximum transmission unit. Let's just say that it's something less than 1500. All right, so imagine somebody came in here and went, okay, I'm gonna set this MTU to 1400. All right, so here we have a situation where the data that we wanna send across that link is larger, the transmission unit, the packet is larger than that link can support. So what this router has to do is it has to say, all right, I gotta make use of IP fragmentation. So to put it simply, what it'll do is it'll take that 15 bytes, it'll break it up across two packets and send them along. So now after the fragmentation, what I'll do is I'll have a 1400 byte packet and one following it that's 100 bytes. All right, so both of those will be sent along and then the receiver, so ultimately when they arrive at the server, it's gonna get a long one of 1400 bytes and then it's gonna get the 100 bytes. It's up to that server to reassemble that packet. And that's called packet reassembly. Now within the IP header itself are the instructions of how that receiver can actually put that data back together. And that's what we're gonna learn about in Wireshark. So let's actually see how this works by sending some large packets. So here I've got two virtual machines. On the left, I've got Windows 10 and on the right, I've got my Kali Linux. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna send a couple of large packets over to Kali Linux and actually watch the fragmentation process happen. But first I want to know what the local MTU is of the interface on the Windows 10 box, just to see, to make sure that I understand what that number is. All right, I'm just going to run network shell interface IPv4 and show interfaces. You can see that command here. And here I see that I have two interfaces available on this Windows 10 box. And the second one is my Ethernet interface. And it tells me that my MTU is 1500. Okay, so that's my maximum transmission unit. That interface will not send anything that's larger than 1500 bytes. So that's something for me to keep in mind. So let's go ahead and set up our ping now. I'm gonna go ahead and type out ping, but this time I'm gonna use the L switch. All right, that's length. So what that allows me to do is set the length of the ping that I'm gonna send out. So I'm just gonna do dash L, I'm gonna type 1600, and then I'm going to send that to my buddy over there, the Kali Linux box. All right, so while that's happening, let me just type in my password there. So on the Linux box, I'm gonna catch that ping and I wanna see what that looks like. So I'm just gonna set up Wireshark over here. I'm just going to start up that capture and I'm gonna come over here to my ping and I'm just gonna let that guy fly. So here on the sender side, it looks pretty normal, right? It just tells me that I have a 1600 byte ping. It doesn't tell me that it's fragmenting it when I'm sending it out. But if I come over here to the receiver, I'm just going to stop my capture. Here I absolutely can see some fragmented traffic. So let's go ahead and take a closer look at what those actually look like. All right, so first of all, here on my first packet that I see come in here. So this is coming in from 215, it's going to my Kali Linux box. Now, if I take a look at the length, 1514, remember that that also includes the Ethernet header. So if I take off 14 bytes of the Ethernet header, then that just leaves me with my 1500 bytes of IP and then encompass data. So if I go ahead and expand, this is my IP header of that 1514 byte packet. I can come here, I see total length is 1500. Remember that that's legit, right? My MTU is 1500. So if I come down to the IP flags, this is where things get interesting. This is where the actual fragmentation instructions happen. If I come down here, I can see that there's more fragments is set. What that means is IP is saying, okay, take this data, but this isn't the only data that existed when this originally was sent. This is a fragmented packet, and there's more data to come after this. All I gotta do is take the identification number, and then I look for another packet with that same IP ID, and that's gonna contain the other part of the data that was originally sent. All right, so let's just keep that in the back of our mind. 53154, that's my IP ID. More fragments, and fragment offset. So this is saying, how far in of the data does this data begin? So since this was the first packet in the fragmentation, the offset here is zero. All right, so this is the data that starts at zero, but there's more fragments to come. Now, how much data are we talking about? Well, if we come down to the encapsulated data, you can see that I've got 1480 bytes encapsulated. 20 bytes are for the IP header itself, but the actual data payload is 1480. Okay, so now let's go to the next packet. This is also from 215, but check this out. The IP ID is the same. If I come down here, no more fragments are to come after this. This is the last packet or the last fragment that's a part of that whole original data set. All right, so the first fragment was from 0 to 1479, and this one's from 1480 and then all the way up to 1600. And this is where Wireshark actually helps us out. If we go down to the second packet here, if I expand this out, I can see that I have two fragments. Frame one is from 0 to 1479, and frame two carries from 1480 to 1607. Now that 1607, that includes a few bytes for the actual ICMP header itself, not the encompassed payload. All right, so the idea here is that when the receiver receives these two fragments, it glues them back together and then passes that data up the stack. So fragmentation, that allows us to get around if we have a low MTU somewhere along the path or any other reason to break up our data along the way. Now, while we're talking about fragmentation, something else to know is that a lot of protocols these days actually use the do not fragment bit set with IP. And if we come down to the flags, you can see do not fragment is not set. So in this ping that I sent out, I didn't set the do not fragment bit. What that means is I'm telling the network along the way or any other interface that may break it up, hey, don't touch this data, don't break it up. Go ahead and keep it whole. So I'm gonna run into a problem if I ever have an interface where I'm trying to send more data than that interface can pass along, then that's where that interface will drop that traffic and it's going to return with an ICMP, hey, I wanted to send your packet, but your do not fragment bit was set. So that's where I would look for an ICMP packet coming back to me from a router warning me that I ran into a low MTU. But just to show you how that works, if I come back to my ping, I'm just gonna go ahead and just say ping, okay? I'm gonna leave that length 1600, but this time I'm gonna say dash F. And notice what happens when I hit enter there. So basically my machine is saying, hey, packet needs to be fragmented, but the do not fragment bit is set. And my local interface is actually the one that's saying that. It's like, hey, I've got a 1500 byte MTU. You're trying to send 1600 bytes. Sorry, pal. If you want me to send this, I can, but you got to let go of that do not fragment bit. So a lot of times when we're dealing with secure protocols, a lot of times we'll see the do not fragment bit because we don't want some attacker to be able to insert fragments instead of the original ones that we intended to send. All right, so now I'm back on my Mac system. I'm gonna go ahead and run an NMAP just against my local gateway. I know that there's port 80 and a couple other things open there, and that'll be interesting to take a look at with NMAP. All right, so I have this set up here, and also notice in the background, I've went ahead and just filtered on traffic going to and from my gateway, and I went ahead and said no SSDP for now. All right, so, and actually, you know what, just for grins, I'm just gonna say, and no DNS. So just give me this NMAP traffic. That's all I wanna see going to and from here in my gateway. All right, so let's go and go back to my terminal. All right, so let's go NMAP. And what we're gonna do is we're going to just do just a stealth scan. And I'm gonna go ahead and say just one port. So let's just do port 80. And the dash F is actually fragmentation. All right, so what I wanna do, you know what, before we do that, let's just take a look at this working normally. 192.168.4.1. All right, let's go ahead and hit it. Oh, wait, NMAP is saying, hold on there, pal. The kind of scan you're doing requires root privileges. So let's go ahead and back up. Just gonna come back here and just say sudo. And it's gonna ask me for my password. All right, so I went ahead and ran this scan. We can see over here on Wireshark. So this was just, it was the stealth scan, right? So I'm just doing synac. I heard back from my gateway and I went ahead and said reset. That's what a stealth scan does. Are you there? Yes, you are. Cool. I'm not going to finish the handshake here with that final packet of the three-way handshake, that final ACK. More on that in another video. But basically, I'm just going to reset it. So we're going to act like nothing happened. All right. So now let's do the same thing, but this time let's fragment it. All right. So I'm going to just hit up arrow and I'm just going to come over here and just say dash F. All right, so that finished and my state is open. So let's come over here to Wireshark and take a look at what that looked like. All right, so what I'm gonna do for you guys is I'm gonna save and share this trace file with you, but just keep in mind that you're gonna have different frame numbers than me just because I'm going to save off just the frames that you see here. All right, so you can follow along with just what I see. Just remember, different frame numbers for you. All right, so here I can see on this packet, just the one that's just after the reset, this says fragmented IP protocol, fragmented IP protocol, and then finally I see a SYN. So basically what Wireshark does is it takes these three fragments, and then in the info area, I can see it's basically reassembled. It tells me what the function of that packet is. And there I see that it's a SYN. But let's take a closer look at that fragmentation. Let's go ahead and do that first fragment. And here I can see that the total length of this packet is 28 bytes. Of that, 20 of it is my header itself, that IP header itself. I can come down here, it says, there's more fragments to come. Now this fragment offset, take this 8 bytes of data, start at 0. So this will be from 0 to fragment offset 7. So the next one's gonna start at 8. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. Let's go to the next fragment. More fragments are coming. So this is not the last fragment that's in this chain. Here we're starting our offset at 8, and we're gonna go to 15, and then the next one will start at 16. So let's go ahead and take a look at that final one. So our fragment offset is 16, but notice at this time, there's no more fragments. This is the last one. So you can go ahead and take those fragments, crunch them all back together, and reassemble them. Now remember, if any of these arrive out of order, then the receiving IP stack knows how to put them back together because of that offset. This shows me where that data goes in that whole packet. And if I come down here, Wireshark teaches me how to put them back together, right? So the payload 0 to 7, 8 to 15, and then 16 to 23. And then that's all of the bytes, all 24 bytes that I was sending in my payload. So you can see how it literally took that 24 bytes of the TCP header and the SYN, and it broke it up into three packets. It made them real small, and that's what NMAP does. It takes a huge IP packet, if you have one. Fragmentation will break it up into smaller chunks, much smaller chunks, which again, the hope is that this will slip by an IDS or maybe even a firewall, and it'll help us to enumerate a system in a different way. Now we can see here that the receiver pieced it together. It took all of those fragments, pieced them together, pushed it up to TCP, and then we went ahead and got a response on port 80. So this device said, great, I'm here, good, SYNAC, and then NMAP went ahead and did that reset. All right, so basically remember how IP fragmentation works. It's just taking a payload and breaking it up into smaller chunks, and then allowing the receiver on the other end, giving it some instructions of how to put those back together. Now, of course, we're gonna have a problem if any of those fragments go missing. If they arrive out of order, the instructions are there. The receiver can go ahead and put them back together. But that's basically how IP fragmentation works. Thanks for stopping by. I hope this helped you understand IP fragmentation, and I'll see you on another video.